Hello guys, and welcome back to caferussiankris.com. Before we start today, I want to show you something. Have a look what I have here. Ta-da! That's typical St. Petersburg houses. So you can see them behind the window. So in our today's meeting, I want to tell you five super useful phrases you will definitely need once you come to Russia. These phrases are mainly for interacting with strangers, not your friends, not your hosts, but strangers in shops, on the streets. Basically, they are answers for very typical situations that might and will happen. Situation number one. When you are in a shop and the shop assistant comes to you and asking, "Могу я помочь? Могу я помочь? Can I help?" So, what can you answer? If you just answer "нет," like "no," you will sound a little bit rude. You might say "спасибо, я просто смотрю." Thank you, I'm just looking. Спасибо, thank you. Я просто just смотрю. Look. Смотрю, it's a form of смотреть. And we have another ending because я is the subject. Спасибо, я просто смотрю. Situation number two. When someone is asking you something and you don't understand what is happening. Извините, я не понимаю. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Извините, I'm sorry, I не понимаю. Don't understand. Понимаю, it's a form of the verb понимать, changed because the subject is я. Я понимаю, I understand. Я не понимаю, I don't understand. Phrase number three. If you want to ask something, how can you start in a polite way? For example, could you tell me please, where is the metro? Скажите, пожалуйста, где метро? Скажите, пожалуйста, could you tell me please? It's a very nice, formal, polite way of starting your question. Скажите, пожалуйста. And then you can say anything you want. Like, где метро? Where is the metro? Сколько время? What's the time? Сколько время? Phrase number four. If you want to pay for something and you want to ask, can you pay cash or card? How can you say it? Можно картой или наличными? Можно картой или наличными? Можно means can I? We skip I because it is redundant. It's understandable, you're asking about you. Можно, can I, карты, with card, или, or, наличными. So, наличные, that's cash. Наличные. So, можно, карты, или наличными. And the very useful phrase number five. In Russia, we have different types of public transport. Most of the transport, they have fixed stops. For example, trams and buses, you can't ask the driver to stop where you need. They have fixed stops, so they will stop there and you can leave or enter. But we have some types of buses, they are called маршрутка. Маршрутка. That's a very typical type of bus. I think we have it only in Russia. These buses, they don't have official stops. If you want this bus to stop, you can just wave and they will stop so you can enter. If you don't wave, they will not stop. And if you want to leave, you need to tell or scream to the driver. Just for example, oh, stop at the corner. Then they will stop for you. These buses are super useful. But, well, for waving, you don't need to know anything extra, just wave. But for stopping, how can you ask them to stop? For example, if you want to say, stop here, please. Остановите здесь. Остановите здесь. So, остановите. That's stop. It's an order, polite order. Stop. Остановите здесь means here. Or instead of здесь, you can put anything you want. Остановите около дома. Stop near this house. Остановите около дома. Около means near. Дома, house. Остановите на остановке. Stop at the stop. Остановите на остановке. And if you want to be super polite, at the end you can add пожалуйста, please. Пожалуйста. All right, guys, this is it for today. I hope it was useful. And now you feel a little bit more comfortable about coming to Russia. And if you are interested in Russian language and looking for a good Russian tutor, I have something interesting for you. I am teaching Russian through a very revolutionary method, which means through speaking practice. We are going to speak at the very first session, even if you don't know a word in Russian. Doesn't matter. Every meeting I will give you some grammar, some vocabulary, and a lot of practice. So by the end of the meeting, you will not only know the theoretical part, but you will feel comfortable of using all this new knowledge. And if you are interested, guys, I will leave my contacts down below so you can send me a message. And I will see you soon in the next video. Пока-пока!